But no matter how effective my powers may be, they're just like a female imitation of the original wall-crawling, web-shooting Spider-Man.
When I started looking into just when exactly the Black Widow officially got red hair, this isn't what I expected. I don't know what I was expecting, but it wasn't this. Greetings, comic lovers, and welcome back to Casually Comics, the channel where we chat all things comics, from reviews of comics new and old, to history, to anecdotes, really wherever our whims take us. Black Widow has a long history over at Marvel Comics, but it was a while before she took on a form many contemporary, at the time of this recording, fans would recognize. Speaking of at the time of this recording, the time is now. The shirt is here.
Look at it. Bask in it. Let me lean all the way back. Get comfy in it.
If you're interested in getting some of your own at the time of this recording merch, I will have the link down below. Let everybody know that you stand for exactly what you're saying at the time of this recording. It's a good time. Black Widow debuted in Tales of Suspense number 52 in 1964 as a villain for Iron Man. However, the Natasha that most think of, with the long red hair and the skin-tight black tactical leather, whatever it is, suit, bodysuit, that one wouldn't appear until Amazing Spider-Man number 86, that in the year 1970. This is in a tale that reads like an insert, or rather, like a backdoor pilot. This is for her own series, or rather, her stint Amazing Avengers, a short-lived run that lasted 8 issues. While her part lasted 8 issues, she shared the book with the Inhumans and they made it 10. Woo! Part of me, the conspiratorial part, can't help but ponder, but wonder if this was a response to DC in some way. In 1969, DC had started Supergirl leading Adventure Comics, and that was going well. She led her run for over 40 issues, 42 to be precise. But that's just me, wearing my finest tinfoil finery. So just how exactly was the Black Widow positioned to spin off into her own series? She had last been seen leaving the Avengers behind, so there was space there, and a look update, a wardrobe change, was definitely welcome, as her original look had become quite dated. However, this is an odd tale. It decides that it's gonna hang its hat on the idea that Black Widow is a female version of Spider-Man, and that she needs to test her mettle, prove herself against him. Why? How? Let's find out. But before we get started, I'm Sasha, and if you're enjoying this content, you know what to do. Hit that like button, hit the subscribe button. Join us on this comic book journey. Beware the Black Widow.
How can I fight her? She's a female copy of myself.
Prepare for Spidey's strangest battle.
No, for that is untrue, but I will prepare for one of his stranger comparisons. This story is from the Stan Lee era of Spider-Man, with art by John Romita Sr. This story is two things. One is your standard Spider-Man story, which at this point largely centered around his struggle balancing being Spider-Man and his personal relationships, particularly with Gwen, who at this point had a highly negative perception of Spider-Man. This story sees Peter once again wrestling, struggling with the concept of, does he want to be Spider-Man at all? All this while he's getting sick, coming down with some kind of mysterious ailment that seems to be robbing him of his powers. The second story is Black Widow, who is there for reasons. This tale opens with Black Widow seeing Spider-Man web by her, which sets off a cascade of thoughts. He'd be the perfect answer to everything I need, especially now when I've decided to begin my career anew. She decides that if she learns the secrets of Spider-Man's powers and then combines them with her own, she'll be unstoppable.
Somehow, there are no more powerful people out there. She just needs Spidey's powers.
And why does she need to be unstoppable? Because she's bored slash guilty, largely guilty. She'd been living her life as a socialite and it's just not working for her. She'd been living as Madame Natasha since she left Hawkeye and consequently the Avengers. My only escape is the forgetfulness that action and danger can bring. She then launches into a very succinct and well-done recap of her backstory to that point, and you will note that she has red hair in the flashback, which is accurate. Her hair was reddish in her first appearance. It's in tales afterwards that it's solidly black, and it remains so for years, up until this point. Perhaps because she was the Black Widow. Maybe because Pepper had red hair. Maybe it was a coloring error. I don't know. All I know is that it fascinates me. There's a funny editor's note here when she's talking about how she was given powers to be able to combat Iron Man, where Stan Lee says he forgot the issue numbers these things happened in, but that Marvel fans will remember. Specifically, he calls them Marvelites, and darn it, he's right. I do remember when this happened. It was Tales of Suspense 64. And they weren't powers, they were tech. She was given boots so that she could adhere to anything and walk on walls, and then she was given this wrist grappling hook line things so that she could shoot, and then if she suspended it to her wrist, she could be attached and she wouldn't fall off, so that she could do things like her namesake, like a spider, the Black Widow. So with these two abilities, she was supposed to be able to take on Iron Man. Why does everybody in early Marvel just feel they can take on this walking, weaponized piece of armor? We recently, at the time of this recording, talked about Marvel's Scarecrow, and he was going up against Iron Man with his skills as a contortionist slash escape artist and trained attack crows. If I was Iron Man, I'd be offended. So Natasha quit being Black Widow after she was involved in the death of Red Guardian, her husband. She tried to bury herself in this vapid lifestyle of luxury, but she just can't. She needs to do something, find meaning, or rather, in this case, atonement. I've got to do what I do best, to fulfill my destiny, to help me forget the haunted past. Her new costume is explained in quite well. It said that she wants to disassociate from all things past Black Widow, except for the name. It's not that intense of a rebrand. It does make sense, though. She got her first costume. It was given to her in her fight against Iron Man by the Soviet Union. We then deal with the Spider-Man portion of this story, which involves him showing up at his apartment where his friends and family are waiting for him. They're all concerned because of the events from last issue where he had to dash off and he ended up fighting the Kingpin. They don't know that, but he's showing up sick and bruised and they're concerned. He can't explain these bruises, and when Gwen presses him about it, he snaps, which prompts her to demand that he stop associating with Spider-Man, which is where she assumes that he got these injuries from. And when he can't promise her that, she storms out. It's a good storm off. Harry goes after her to drive her. That's how good of a storm off it is. But wait, we're not gonna leave this scene without some 1960s Marvel advice about females from Captain Stacy.
Oh boy, I can't wait.
I understand, son, but Gwen is a female, and like all females, she thinks with her heart.
Captain Stacy's gonna make me make an intense Muppet face. And now that we've concluded one of the longest opening scene-setting introductions in comic book history, let's see if we can get our story going while we're still young enough to care. Are you okay, Stan? What is the tone this box is going for? Is it a joke? Is it salty? I don't know, but it gave me a weird vibe. That's why I read it like that. I'm not sure. Let's just enjoy Black Widow's new outfit. Sleek, stylish, classic. No need to modify it much. It's simple, but effective. It may not be as fancy, but this new costume will be more in keeping with the swingy 70s and with the modern image of the new Black Widow. She then goes on to detail each part of the costume and what its function is so that it's not purely ornamental. Nothing on her costume is ornamental. It all does something. Then it gets odd, but no matter how effective my powers may be, they're just like a female imitation of the original wall-crawling, web-shooting Spider-Man. This whole thing is odd to me. Yes, Black Widow has a spider-themed name, but the term Black Widow also has other connotations. Yes, she has boots and adheres, and she shoots a grappling hook, nylon line-style thing. However, was this a common sentiment? Like, was this a thing? The idea that Black Widow is just a bootleg female version of Spider-Man is not one I had heard before. It doesn't really track, either. When she was introduced, it was a femme fatale spy, and then she got the abilities later. But she'd already been established as a spy turned defector, and that femme fatale aspect was played up with her relationship with Hawkeye, and then her spy pedigree was utilized by S.H.I.E.L.D. Black Widow also has a romantic colloquial meaning of dangerous woman, so that element is in play as well. So at least to me, it never crossed my mind that, oh, there goes the female version of Spider-Man. Although now there are many Spider-Man derivatives, some of them female, and Spider-Woman, Jessica Drew, and others have been around for decades. So perhaps this was a sentiment I was just too late for and had faded into the memory hole. Or perhaps this is some kind of editorial thing. There's a weird snipey vibe to some of this. Or maybe this is just a very contrived way to have Black Widow have a reason to be in Spider-Man's book. This because they're using Spider-Man series as a launching pad for her own. This interaction will see her challenging him to see why his powers are greater than hers. I'm not sure how she's gonna glean this by fighting him, but go on then. I'm already here. I must prove myself his equal. Or, you know, do your own thing as you're already an established character and don't need his validation or approval. This issue is making me salty. Not even how amazing this costume is can stop it. I do like that Jonah spots her and assumes that Spider-Man has put some woman up to doing a female Spidey act to confuse the public. That makes so little sense, but it's entirely in keeping with Jonah's mindset. I love it. I hope he prints it on the first page. Peter is feeling terribly weak. Faint, can't focus, knees are heavy, palms are sweaty, so he decides that he's gonna go out web swinging. That'll help. If it isn't anything serious, then a good workout ought to clear my head. Go home, Amazing Spider-Man 86, you're drunk. While out on this web swing that will cure his mysterious illness tour, Black Widow spots him and they fight. He lures her in close by feigning that he's hurt so that he can attack. Well, it's actually so he can see who's attacking him and then attack. A female, one that I never saw before. She tells him that she's Black Widow and he remembers, hey, weren't you on the Avengers? Why are you attacking me? And her response is to attack him even harder.
Look, a girl can get hurt up here. Give me your hand and I'll help you down.
She was on the Avengers. I'm pretty sure she can get down. Don't think I'm helpless just because I'm soft and cuddly. Ah yes, the skin tight bodysuit, a sign of soft cuddleability. We've got to rebrand the leather club and the spandex club. Just any bodysuit club, rebrand it. Soft and cuddly. Spider-Man is losing and Black Widow is disappointed. She wanted more of a challenge. She had to beat the more powerful male version of herself that he totally isn't. Look, Spider-Man, for a so-called living legend, you're a king-size disappointment to me. Where are you reading this good Spider-Man press, Natasha? Point me in that direction. I only subscribe to the Daily Bugle. I wanted to learn what I could from you by attacking you. Power? You're a laugh. You're the biggest washout since the flood.
That was a Noah's Ark joke. What a burn.
I heard enough, lady. No curvy carbon copy is gonna swipe my style. There's only room for one Spider-Man in town.
Ah, that statement's truer than hold up, did it?
But with that level of snark, you know he's got a second wind. He's rallying. I got my powers through training and unique weapons.
Yes, yet another reason that you're not a carbon copy of him. But please continue.
But the way he moves, the way he fights and uses his strength, it's like he was born that way.
Yes,
almost like certain members of the Avengers, a team that she was a part of.
What were they?
Something that started with an M, something that gave you powers that you were born with, something that meant that you needed to be endorsed by the X-Men so that even if you weren't on the team, you would know about said people who had those abilities on that team. Mutants! It was mutants!
None of this should be shocking. I'm broken a little bit inside.
So she goes home, saying that his secrets are going to stay with him.
Then it just pivots and she decides that she's super unique and she never needed to prove herself to him in the first place.
I'm so glad then that we spent most of the issue doing that. I have my own unusual powers, my own style of combat, and my own strange destiny to fulfill. So whatever dangers lie ahead, I'll face them my way. As the Black Widow.
This is what happens when you order your motivation from Wish.
And then Peter goes home and realizes that he is sick and it could be something serious and maybe he's losing his powers. And how does he feel about that? Let's find out.
The end. Natasha's segment ended with a little blurb directing you over to Amazing Tales, which is not even what the comic she starred in is called.
But you're supposed to go there and check her out on her own. Though I dare say after this, I'm not entirely sure why you would be inclined to.
It didn't give hugely compelling reasons to do so, at least in my opinion, outside of the look. This comic. Okay, first, positives. This costume looks great. It's a good update on her old look that gave her an iconic feel that has stood the test of time. The recap of her backstory is very good and makes a case for all the interesting pathos she has. Most of the rest of it has aged incredibly poorly. The whole I need to prove myself against Spidey for I am his female counterpart plays quite badly, and even more so at the time of this recording. It feels quite frustrating as Black Widow was already more than that, and had always been more than that. It just felt, at least to me, like an odd and lazy comparison to make. The idea seemed to stem from their spider names and little else, and a couple of ability similarities, but a lot of heroes and characters have abilities that overlap. It does her a disservice to set her up for her own series and then spend the majority of her backdoor pilot saying she's just a curvy Spider-Man. The whole I'm my own character and I can do it on my own, I don't need any kind of validation or permission is just one panel and then kind of implied by her backstory panels.
It also doesn't give you an idea as to what kind of adventure she's going to have, and while it does give glimpses into other aspects of her personality, they're all quite brief. Like the one panel where she says she enjoys soaring through the air. That introduces liking the thrill of being Black Widow alongside the trauma of it. This does feel like it's either a flimsy excuse for her to be in Spider-Man's comic, which they're using as a springboard since he's so popular, it'll get eyes on her and her new series as a result, or as some kind of dig against Black Widow. Maybe both. If the latter wasn't intended, that's certainly how some parts read. There is some good character work established in setting up slash cementing the Black Widow's guilt complex, that desire to make up for the harm that she's caused. This is an idea that has stayed with the character, and it's carried on through to adaptations such as the MCU, the whole I've got red in my ledger. However, there are still a fair few little sexist digs in this one. And that pitting against Spider-Man that goes on throughout her time in this story distracts from some of the stronger elements of her characterization.
Or perhaps I'm responding emotionally, for I am female, and as Captain Stacy says, that means my brain is down here. Near my at the time of this recording shirt.
So I need to hear from you. What did you think of the intro to a modern Black Widow?
Marn at the time.
Do you think the Black Widow is a female copy of Spider-Man? Was this a prevalent thought? What do you think of her new costume? Do you work out when you get sick? Tell me things down below, and while you're down there, please do all the YouTube things. Like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell notification so that you never miss a vid. Thanks so much for taking some time out of your day to spend discussing comics with me. I always appreciate it, and I will see you again soon. Bye-bye.